What's happening, Munchers? My name is Harsh.
I'm Shreyas.
And what are we doing today, Bhatia?
We're doing Z2.
Zombieland Double Tap.
Yeah.
So first and foremost, if you've been a fan of Zombieland, this movie's been away for like 10 years. We're getting a sequel after 10 years.
Yep, long
and
time.
Even in the movie, 10 years have passed, so yep. They've done that really well. The entire cast is back, yep. Everyone that you loved from the first movie is back.
Yep.
And the director's back after Venom.
Yeah, I couldn't cut it in the film, so had to come back to zombie world.
Yeah, so, but yeah, all in all, there's a lot going on in this movie.
Yes.
And there are obviously new additions to the cast.
Yeah.
A lot of fresh faces and a lot of fun to be had. So Let's just dive into the goods, man.
Let's do this. So my favorite character, she's brand new. She's living in a freezer and she's fantasy.
This girl is... Who's the actor? I keep forgetting her name.
Yeah, Zoe. First name Zoe, second name...
Don't kill us, don't sue us, please. Alright, so first and foremost, she's such a breath of fresh air.
She is...
In the entire cast, it's always a blast having her on screen.
Totally. I mean, considering how the original cast has their own personalities and their own quirks.
And even the chemistry between them is really good in itself.
Yeah. To get like a totally new character, just like steal the show every time she's there. So she's your typical bimbo, blonde,
absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. But she does it so well. She pulls it off, and every time you're like, this is gonna be generic, you just end up laughing somehow or the other. I was in stitches every time she was on screen.
Yeah,
so I had a really good time with her, man.
Yeah, it's because like it's a tense situation, even though it's a funny movie.
Yeah.
The concept of surviving zombies is tense, but
Acropolis.
Yeah, but. But she's still doing her own thing, and that's so hilarious.
Absolutely, it's really her addition to this. I think cast in itself, it elevated the entire movie.
Yeah.
I had a lot of fun with her.
Yeah.
Apart from that, the cast is back. Who does not like this cast? Woody Harrelson, Emma Stone, Lil Rock, Jesse Eisenberg.
Yeah.
So
these guys haven't aged like a single. Listen, they look exactly the same.
Woody Harrelson for being so old.
Yeah. Pretty cool. Jesse Eisenberg, you can't expect much, same hairstyle, same rules.
Yeah.
Except that now he's in love and he's got his family.
Oh yeah, absolutely. That's the dynamics of all obviously evolved and changed over the past 10 years.
Yeah.
They're living in White House now.
Yes.
And the story picks up from Little Rock kind of running away, abandoning them to find her place in the world.
Right. So
and that becomes like the journey part of it.
Correct.
So and all in all, I think there's a lot of fun to be had. I was laughing throughout the movie.
Yeah.
There are some times where the narrative is not that great. We'll get that into the badge. But overall, I think there's a lot of fun to be had when you're watching this movie.
Yeah, man. The kills, bro. The monster.
Oh, zombie kill of the year now.
Oh.
They upgrade from the week.
Oh my God. Yeah, that was insane. And like just to see them like show off a little with that monster trap.
Yeah, absolutely.
Whoa,
that was a lot of fun. So a lot of good set pieces there as well.
Yeah.
And a lot of fun to be had, but there are definitely some negatives here. So let's dive into the bads as well.
Yeah. Okay, considering how good the original cast is, I know you too, did not like Lil Rock. She was this nice, cute little girl doing her thing.
The
first one. Had a nice little sister dynamic going on with like a very Bonnie and Clyde thing.
Right.
Like they only trust each other, blah, blah, blah. And now she wants to set off on her own and she doesn't really like relate to everything going on. Woody Harrelson's too much of a father figure. Her sister potentially has a proper full-on boyfriend.
Right.
So she's like, I want people my own age. I want to do my own thing.
Yeah.
And she runs away. And
didn't work.
Yeah, just the way she is. I think she hasn't aged well. She doesn't look good at all.
She's living in Acropolis, man. Alright, but I completely agree with what you said. I couldn't have put it better.
Yeah.
All the other cast members, they've aged well. Even though they have matured over the 10 years, even the characters in the movie, over the 10 years, they're still all very likable, apart from Little Rock.
Yeah.
She's probably the only one that you don't get to latch onto, and she does not have any special moments where, kind of like, that make her appeal to you as an audience.
Yeah, except the climax.
Yeah, there's not much that she's doing there. Absolutely.
Yeah.
So I think Little Rock was a little of a letdown from the entire cast.
Right.
And apart from that, like I already said, the narrative and the pacing does kind of drag in the middle.
Yeah.
But all in all, there's always humor sprinkled out really well throughout the movie. So I always had a lot of fun with it. At no point I think the movie is dragging, even though the narrative is a little on and off sometimes.
Correct.
Apart from that, one small, this is like a very small nitty gritty gripe that I have.
Mm.
They showed a lot of cool new
zombies. Exactly.
But they didn't utilize them enough.
Yeah.
So I'm really hoping maybe in the future sequels, when people have kind of forgotten about the ninja, he just comes running from the shadows or something like that. Yeah, but they've introduced a lot of new zombies. They're kind of evolving with time as well, which is a very cool concept, even for world building.
Yes.
So yeah, it's fun to watch, but yeah.
But yeah, I mean, yeah, just coming from the first movie, because I literally saw the first movie like a couple of weeks ago.
Right.
And that was a nice, short, sweet movie. I love how, you know, it went from beginning, middle, end. I love how they sprinkled those rules. I like how those rules are animated.
Awesome,
yeah. Yeah, somehow the second movie, is it a pacing thing? I don't know. Is it trying to build on how good the first one was? Because you always suffer from that sequelitis, so to say.
Yeah, but this is one movie that I think it didn't. Like, it wasn't trying to rest too much on the previous movie.
Mm.
And it's trying to do its own thing.
Maybe, but I would still rather watch the first one again. I
wasn't back-to-back together, man. I think that would be fun, right? With Madison.
Yeah, exactly. if I had to watch the second one, I'd just watch her scenes. So, yeah, that's pretty much about it. Not too much bad.
Let's get
into
the film, yeah.
Oh, bad, sorry. But the post-credits, what the hell was that? The first post-credit was good. The follow-up was what?
Espanol.
Oh my god. Please, guys.
Do stick for the post-credit scene. Do stick for the mid-credit scene.
Mid-credit scene, exactly. Yeah, cool. Let's do some filming.
All in all, I think this movie does a really good job in capturing the vibe of Zombieland, because the first movie did such a good job in establishing the world.
Yes.
And, you know, creating this nice, fun vibe, even though it's a post-apocalyptic world.
Yeah.
It's a good companion piece to the first one. And obviously 10 years have passed, these guys have kind of aged and matured as characters, and their relationships as well have evolved, and they do a good job of showing that. So I really like the world building around there as well, especially with the zombies and the new cast coming in, all these other actors coming in, you know, playing, you know, small part.
Yeah.
What's her name? Rosario Dawson. Yeah,
exactly.
I'm sorry if I got a name wrong.
No, that's
but yeah,
not
she's
right.
also a new part of the cast.
She's
so
kick
all,
ass.
Absolutely. So all these new, you know, characters coming in, adding more to the world.
Yeah.
I think all of that I had a lot of fun with.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Definitely a good popcorn flick to watch, man.
I'd say so. Yeah. Even they have this established mecca where there are no guns, there are no violence, and these guys have to end up like taking refuge there, which is pretty cool. And even that end scene, just the way everything works, it was pretty good.
And it was very Zombielandish.
It was very Zombieland. So I get it. But yeah, for me, the extra cast really, like, they were put in really well here and there. And yeah, overall, minus the part that it's not a straightforward beginning, middle, end.
Right.
It was a little hopscotch, but overall, a fun ride. Nice.
This movie had humor, this movie had heart, had good action. Had a lot of fun moments and a lot of good set pieces sprinkled throughout.
Yeah.
So definitely do give this one a watch. As for the ratings, let's come down to the ratings.
Yeah. As much as I like the second movie, I still prefer the first one. I'll still go back to the first one if I have to watch it. So this was...
No, Madison. We all lost.
Okay, so how about I just sprinkled Madison the first one. That'll be my old genius move. But yeah, this is definitely worth a watch. It's a nice popcorn flick, like he said. No brainer, have a good time,
absolutely.
Pop that popcorn inside and just go along for the ride.
So yeah, I agree with all of that, but I think I had a little more fun than you did.
Yeah.
I really enjoy Zombieland movies. I really love zombies in itself. Post-apocalyptic, give it to me any day. I'm a morbid guy, so yeah, I'm gonna definitely give this a thumbs up.
Ooh, interesting.
So that wraps up our review of Zombieland 2, Double Tap. Do let us know in the comments below which one you prefer, Zombieland 1, 2, or do you actually prefer it in one go, like 1 and 2 together?
Madison's favorite scenes, yo.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
She's sprinkled all over the place.
Throughout the movie.
Doing exactly the same stuff. It's still so cool. Just
it's
to have
amazing watching her.
Yeah.
So yeah, let us know how you like the movie, and I would definitely recommend it to you. Be back for more, guys.